from $50 to $50,000. This is the kind of art that attracted big bucks buyers in the most expensive window shopping suburb in the world, Beverly Hills. But Ron Artis decided to take his art and leave the company of Gucci and Tiffany in exchange for the comfort of Kailua.
One of the most intense questions that's asked to me all the time, Ron, when you were on Rodeo Drive, you were doing so well. Why in the world would you leave? It's very simple. The people on Rodeo Drive only bought for me because I was on Rodeo Drive. I wanted to paint for the family, so I found a place where I could paint for the families, and the rich and famous would not mind coming to me also.
An artist and musician of international caliber, Ron's 15 years in the record business aligned him with such big-name performers as Harry Belafonte, Luther Vandross, the Jamar. But you won't see much Hollywood here in Kailua, where Ron's studio is. What you'll see and hear is lots of talent, all emanating from his freewheeling fingertips.
Music and art is one for me. I like to start the day off playing, getting the juices going, getting creative things going in my mind, then I'm ready to paint with all the power I got in me.
As a jazz and funk artist whose father played with Ike and Tina Turner for 15 years, Ron's artistic talents have been in the works as long as his music has. And while his music lives on a number of albums from the past, his airbrushing lives on just about anything that'll take paint.
Throughout my life, I've studied hard to master all the different mediums, but the airbrush has been the medium that allowed me to paint on everything. I have absolutely no artistic limitations with airbrush.
Hey, Ron.
Hey, how you doing?
Oh, pretty good. I hear you can paint pictures on anything.
Absolutely.
Well, I was wondering if you could paint my girl on the side of the computer.
Definitely. Need it today?
Yeah.
You got it.
Oh, thanks.
All right.
So early every morning when Ron wakes up, the big question is, who is going to bring him what to paint? And nothing makes him happier than an unusual project.
My daily challenge, which I love so much, is that I never know who's going to walk through that door, what they're going to bring in. They may bring in a mailbox, a doghouse, they may bring in a little thing that they have on their keychain that they want me to put something on and to make it different. That's what I love, because I never know what my next project is going to be.
But even though Ron's happy that you and I, regular folks, enjoy his work, he has a special personal pride that some of his legendary musical friends like his work too.
When Harry Belafonte came into my store, I was so excited at the fact that this man would take time out to come into my space. But I was even more surprised after he began to talk to me, and I found that this guy thought and acted in his heart the same way I did. That was perfect validation that Ron Artis was right on schedule. Just being yourself and letting the art flow was a natural thing to do.
Ron's list of artiste-loving celebrities includes folks like Jody Watley, Jermaine Jackson, and Axl Rose, just to name a few. But to him, the biggest stars are the local folks that he pleases. That's why he came here in the first place.
This particular story, it's the answer to all my dreams. All my life, I've always heard, Ron, you can't do your music and your art at the same time. I found the perfect place here in Hawaii to execute both talents at the same time and to have both talents fully appreciated by the community.
Now, you'd think Ron had it made, living in Beverly Hills, dealing with the rich and famous on a daily basis. But his view of life is more than fancy cars and mansions of the stars. Although he's an artist of many talents, Ron says he's a family man first. And in his mind, Hawaii is the best place to be.